The call was made by Jenna Lunga, Executive Director of Northern and Eastern Africa Trade Information and Negotiations Institute Uganda, Siatini, while presenting their petition to the leader of the opposition, Mathias Mpuuga, where they cited the Energy Charter Treaty with problematic clauses that only require disputes to be handled at international courts, which undermines the sovereignty and makes it costly for Uganda in terms of litigation.
If an investor takes government to court, it isn't our court here. It's the court scene in Europe that has challenges when it comes to resources, but it's also an issue of sovereignty.
The leader of opposition, Mpuuga, welcomed the recommendation made by Siatini, revealing that although the Minister of State for Regional Affairs, John Mulumba, tabled a list of 270 protocols and treaties signed and ratified by Uganda, government fell short of tabling all these treaties.
Actually, it seems to be a contradiction between the Constitution and the Ratification of Treaties Act, in which case the Constitution should have stood that every treaty or protocol be brought before Parliament for ratification. So it does seem that a lot is going on without the knowledge of Parliament. And therefore, the red flag raised by Siatini should enable us to ask further questions and get to understand who is signing what on our behalf.
Mpuuga was backed up by the Shadow Minister of Foreign Affairs, Muanda Nkunyenje, who noted that time has come to have all trade agreements and treaties be subjected to parliamentary approval.
Now, when we hear from civil society that a treaty is problematic, it becomes a matter of urgency for us as opposition to dig through the intricacies and the dangers so that we have a position to advocate for, so that we save our country where possible.
The Energy Charter Treaty, ECT, was signed in 1994 and currently has 54 signatories. However, it has recently become contentious and a number of governments in Europe, including France, Germany, Netherlands, among others, are pulling out after recognizing how damaging it is to their climate commitments.
The moment we sign, we are not allowed to go ahead with the establishment of other regulations for climate change management or for reducing on emissions. We are not allowed. And now I see, I'm beginning to feel, could that be the reason why regulations, the Climate Change Act, are delaying?
I doubt whether our government knows how many treaties we have signed, where they are, who signed them, what are our obligations under those treaties. But any treaty which is signed by a government official is binding on us.
Activists are worried with the recent commitment by the government to Uganda to join the contentious treaty. Report compiled by Fred Kajuri for the news.